In this video, we're continuing on with our Multiplying Rational Expressions worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section, picking up where we left off with number 8. Now, from the previous worksheet, we know how important it is to simplify at the start in order to have less work towards the end. So looking at number 8, there are many things I'll be able to cancel out first. In our numerator, we have the term n plus 4, so n plus 4 will cancel out with that n plus 4 in the denominator. Also note that in the numerator, we have n minus 3, and in the denominator, we have that same binomial n minus 3. N minus 3 divided by n minus 3 is 1, so I can also cancel that out. That leaves me with 7n squared in the numerator, and in our denominator, n plus 8 times n plus 6. So 7n squared over n plus 8 times n plus 6 is our solution in number 8. And remember, we're simplifying, so there's no need to multiply out or FOIL out that denominator. We can leave it as n plus 8 times n plus 6. Let's move on to number 9. In number 9, again, I'll start by simplifying. So I have p minus 3 in my numerator, and I also have p minus 3 in my denominator. P minus 3 divided by the quantity p minus 3 is 1. Also note that I have a 2 in my numerator and a 2 in my denominator, so those will cancel out. 2 divided by 2 is 1. So this leaves me with p plus 6 as my numerator and 4 in my denominator. So my solution in number 9 is p plus 6 divided by 4. In number 10, right away, I can cancel out r plus 4 because r plus 4 divided by r plus 4 is 1. So I can cancel out r plus 4 in my numerator and the r plus 4 in my denominator. Also note that I have 9 in my numerator, and I actually have it twice, and I also have 1 9 in my denominator, so I can cancel out one of those. So let's just go ahead and cancel out that first 9. 9 divided by 9 is 1. So now I'll have 1 times 9r, which is 9r, over what's left within my denominator, which is r minus 5. So my solution in number 10 is 9r divided by r minus 5. In number 11, right away, I have 8 times n plus 1 in my numerator, and I also have 8 times n plus 1 in my denominator. So 8 divided by 8 is 1, and n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 is 1. So in my numerator, all I'll have left is 9, and then in my denominator, when I multiply that out, all I'll have left is 7m, since this numerator canceled out with this denominator. Therefore, my solution in number 11 is 9 divided by 7m. In number 12, I have p minus 4 in my numerator, and I have p minus 4 two separate times in my denominator. So I'm going to cancel out one of those. P minus 4 divided by p minus 4 is 1. So multiplying out my numerator, since I cannot simplify any further at the start, p plus 6 times 1 is simply p plus 6, and that's all over p minus 4 times p minus 2. That is my final solution in number 12, because I cannot simplify any further. Now, looking at number 13 at the start, there's nothing that I can divide to give me 1, or essentially there's nothing that I can cancel out. However, let's multiply out the numerator and the denominator. So 1 times 10v plus 30 is 10v plus 30, and that's divided by v plus 10 times v plus 3. So I'll leave those as their binomials, v plus 10 times v plus 3. Now note that in my numerator, 10v plus 30, I can simplify this by pulling out a 10. If I pull out a 10 from each of those terms, I'll have 10 times v plus 3. And you can see that if I was to redistribute that 10, 10 would get multiplied to v to be 10v, and 10 would get multiplied to 3 to be 30 with addition in between. So that's my new numerator, or my simplified numerator, and I'll divide that by v plus 10, or v plus 3. Now you can see that I have v plus 3 in both my numerator and denominator, so those will get canceled out to equal 1. Therefore, my solution in number 13 is 10 over v plus 10. I have 10 in my numerator and v plus 10 remaining in my denominator. Now, number 14 will be the last problem that I go over in this video. If you haven't done so already, please remember to click that like button and subscribe to my channel if you found any of these helpful. So now looking at number 14, I'm going to simplify at the start. I have 7 in both my numerator and my denominator, so I'm going to cancel those out because 7 divided by 7 is 1. So I have 9 minus 24 divided by 24 cubed minus 64 squared. I can simplify my numerator. I can simplify that because there's a 3 that I can pull out. 3 times 3n equals 9n, and I'll be subtracting 3 times 8 because 3 times 8 is 24. So my numerator I rewrote as 3 times 3n minus 8. And my denominator I can also pull out common terms because both 24 and 64 are divisible by 8, so I'll pull out an 8, but also note that n cubed and n squared are both divisible by n squared, so I'll pull out an n squared as well. So 8n squared times some quantity will give me 24n cubed, and that's 3n, because 8 times 3 is 24, and n squared times n is n cubed. And I'm going to be subtracting 8n squared times 8, because 8n squared times 8 equals 64n squared. Now from that, you can see that I have 3n minus 8 in both my numerator and denominator, and when I divide those, they will equal 1. And 1 times any quantity is that quantity that 1 is multiplied by. So if I have 3 over 8n squared times 1, my answer will be 3 divided by 8n squared. And I cannot simplify 3 and 8 any further. So 3 divided by 8n squared is my final solution on this video. If you didn't do so before number 14, don't forget to click that like button. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Continue on to the next video, where I'll complete the next 7 problems on this worksheet. And as always, if you have a comment, go ahead and leave it below.